Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning channel. In this video, we'll cover rendering and exporting multi-channel media directly from the batch flow graph. This can definitely help you in multi-channel workflows, as well as facilities that take advantage of a multi-channel pipeline throughout their production. Now, this video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. As a quick recap, in the previous versions of Flame, you could import multi-channel media through the Media Hub or the Batch Import node. So switching to the Media Hub, you would navigate to the multi-channel media, and you would set the clip import options to multi-channel clip. When you import the EXRs, you get a single clip that is recognized as multi-channel media with access to all the channels in batch. You can press Shift-C to expand the clip and see all the channels. Alternatively, if you use the Batch Import node, the import options automatically default to multi-channel clip, so you can just select the clip and import it. You get the same result as the Media Hub, and you can expand the clip with Shift-C. Now you can input and output multi-channel data throughout the batch flow graph. It's also quite common to create your own multi-channels through various nodes. So you could have data passes like position or vector data from action, or you could be making multi-channel mats for compositing or grading further down the production pipeline. These can be 16-bit or 32-bit, and it is happily handled within the batch environment. Now, when it comes to rendering and exporting multi-channel media from batch, the render and write nodes have received significant upgrades in Flame 2019. So let's say you need to output a beauty pass with some matte passes and data passes. Firstly, drag out a render node from the batch node bin and place it at the end of your flow graph. When you double-click the render node for its controls, you'll note that the render format is set to RGBA. So this is your standard image with an alpha. To create a multi-channel clip, you need to ensure the bit depth is at least 16-bit, and you would click the pull-down menu and change the option to multi-channel. Next, you can define how many channels should be in the multi-channel clip. Now in this example, we have a beauty pass, two matte passes, and two data passes. So set the number of channels to 5. Looking at the render node, for each channel you have a primary input and a matte or alpha input. The node inputs get quite squashed with quite a few channels, so press Shift-C to expand the render node. We'll go ahead and connect the various inputs into the different channels. As a tip, you can also toggle Shift-Alt to extend the arm of each input to connect the multi-channels even faster. It is also important to note that for Flame 2019, you cannot manually name the channels. This is currently done automatically by Flame. Now, when you select the render node and toggle F4, this allows you to cycle the channels within the render node. So this is what you're going to land up with once we've rendered the multi-channel clip. I'll press the render button to render the flow graph, and we'll take a look at the multi-channel clip once the render is complete. If we drag this new clip back into the batch schematic, you can uncollapse the node with Shift-C, and if you toggle F4, you can go through all the channels that are part of the multi-channel clip. At this point, I do want to mention that the multi-channel clip works with the connected conform, batch groups, and the smart replace. The multi-channel clip could also be used in Luster as a standalone clip or even part of the connected color workflow. So the multi-channel clip works within the various areas of the Flame family. If you wanted to export multi-channel media from Flame, you have two workflows. Firstly, if the multi-channel clip already exists, like this one here, you just switch to the Media Hub and drag the clip into your designated directory. In the Media Export window, you'll ensure it is set to File Sequence and choose a format that supports multi-channel media. In this case, you can choose from any of the OpenEXR presets. Expand the Advanced Options, and in the Video menu, you need to enable multi-channel as part of the export. If you don't, Flame will only export the first RGBA channel into the EXR files. So that's exporting multi-channel EXRs if the multi-channel clip already exists in Flame. The second workflow is exporting multi-channel EXRs directly from Batch. Delete the render node and go back to the Batch node bin. This time, drag out a write node and put it at the end of the flow graph. When you call up the write node controls, it has similar settings to the render node. Firstly, change the export format to OpenEXR. This allows you to set the bit depth to either 16 or 32-bit. Secondly, click the Format pull-down menu and change the format from RGBA to multi-channel. If you do not choose the OpenEXR option first, the multi-channel format settings would be unavailable. Now, as before, set the number of channels to 5 and expand the write node with Shift-C. Go ahead and connect up the various channel and data passes to the write node. Once you're done, you can select the write node and cycle through the channels with F4. All that's left to do is set up a destination path, create an open clip if you're using that workflow, and apply any color management through the other menus if required. Pressing render at this point will generate the multi-channel OpenEXR media. So in Flame 2019, you can import multi-channel media as a single clip, work with all the various image and data passes, and finally render out your results as a single multi-channel clip for further work within your production pipeline. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.